Hi, I'm Zita Bano, and the book that I'm going to talk about today is The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath. And I am also a student of gender studies, and in gender studies, fiction writers such as Sylvia Plath and Virginia Woolf, they have a very respectable and notable place. So I wanted to talk a bit about The Bell Jar and its impact on feminist ideology and feminism itself. Basically, Bell Jar is a story of a girl, Esther. Esther is from a small town, and then she moves to New York because she gets a scholarship there, and she starts working with a very notable magazine. While she is working with that magazine, she's also navigating her friendships, she's experimenting a bit with her style. At the same time, she is getting in and out of different relationships. But that is a very simplistic description of this book, because this book is much more than that. This book talks about mental illnesses, it talks about depression, it talks about anxiety. And mind you that this book was written in 1960s, which means that somebody was talking about mental illnesses and how it impacts your day-to-day life, how it impacts different spheres of your life in 1960s. And even today, if you talk about mental illness, people sort of judge you, because if you tell them that, you know, I have a terminal disease, they are going to sympathize with you. But if you tell them that I am struggling with depression or anxiety, the first response that you will get is, get over it. Or if you tell them that I am actually seeking therapy because I am not feeling okay, I am depressed, they will judge you. They will think that there is something wrong with you. So somebody talking about these things explicitly in 1960s was a remarkable thing in itself. And that's why I think Bell Jar as a piece of fiction was revolutionary at that time. Sylvia Plath, in her book, she talks about her struggle with mental illnesses in great detail. And that's probably the reason that this book has been banned, because when she was talking about her struggle with mental illnesses, she gives you explicit details, and she talks about it in a very descriptive, in a very graphic manner. And when you're reading it, you feel like that this is something that you are also going through with Esther. And one interesting thing about this novel is that it is a semi-autobiography, which means that Sylvia Plath has incorporated her own experiences in this book. Besides that, she also talks about how she's struggling with her career and also with relationships. She is trying to manage both her career and relationships, and she's struggling because of that. And I have read classic fiction. In classic fiction, usually writer focus on one thing. If they're talking about their romantic life, they're just going to focus on that. If they're talking about depression or anxiety or existential crisis, like Franz Kafka did, they only focus on that. They don't go into the spheres of relationship or their family life. But Sylvia Plath, in her book, discusses everything. She discusses her entire life, or Esther's entire life. And that is the reason that I believe that this book holds a lot of value in feminist literature, because she presented a very humanistic portrayal of women in her book. Because women, they can be very ambitious, they can be very audacious. At the same time, they would want a relationship as well. And this is something that is still somewhat not understood properly by our society. If a woman is career oriented, then it is expected of her that she would not get into a relationship, because she won't be able to manage a relationship. And at the same time, if she is very family oriented, then it is expected of her that she would not be career oriented, because these two things in our society, they cannot go hand in hand. And she was explaining her struggle in that book 70 years ago, and that is probably the reason that it holds so much value. And another thing about this book is, besides its impact and besides why it's so important, it's how beautifully it is written. Because Sylvia Plath is essentially a poet, was essentially a poet, and when she was writing this book, she incorporated a lot of prose in it, and she talked about these dilemmas. She talks about the difficulties in her life in a very poetic manner. She's talking about her struggles, she's talking about her anxiety in a poetic manner. This is something that I really, really enjoyed in this book. And as I said before, that she gave a very humanistic portrayal of women. She also elaborates that experience and experience of a woman in a very realistic manner, because it is expected of us most of the time that we would be polite and we would be happy and we are these perfect home creating creatures. But that is not the case. We go through different things. Life is not a bed of roses, not for you, not for me, not for anyone. And we women, although we pretend we put up a brave face, but we struggle internally a lot. And Sylvia Plath, in her book, she explores that topic. She talks about how Esther, who is very creative, who is very intelligent, but at the same time, she's struggling internally a lot, and she knows that she is struggling, and she's suicidal because of that. And Sylvia Plath has normalized that. After reading that book, I felt like that it's okay to be depressed sometimes. It's okay to struggle with things sometimes because everything is not perfect all the time. I am a human being and I struggle with things, and sometimes you need that sort of confirmation from other people that it's okay to be not okay. And lastly, I have read a lot of classic fiction. Like, classic fiction is something that I have been reading a lot lately, but one thing that I feel is missing in classic fiction is that its relevancy. The classic fiction that you read is not very relevant today, but the bell jar is still relevant because these are the questions that we are still facing. These are the questions that are still being asked from us. What do you want to do in life? Don't you want to get married? Why don't you settle? Why don't you find a handsome or a rich boy? These are the questions that we still have to face. So I think the relevancy of the bell jar, what Esther was going through at that time, is something that we are still going through. And I think this is the best thing about the bell jar. So yeah, that's about it. I think these are the things that I wanted to talk about the bell jar, and this is the book that I actually really really enjoyed while I was reading it. So I was really really excited about talking about this book. I hope you like this video. Let me know in the comment section, and see you next time with another video.